Okay, California, you calling in for a session?
Hello?
Yeah, so you calling in for a session?
Yes, I am, Evangelist King. Thank you for taking my call.
Uh-huh, and who am I speaking with? That's the first name.
Yeah, you're speaking with Demetrius.
Demetrius, okay. How you find out about me, Demetrius?
I found you on YouTube about a year ago. And
a year ago?
Yeah, but at the time, things didn't click. So I, went on, from that. And then recently the Lord brought me back, and then everything clicked. And the Lord really started working very mightily in my life. And he exposed the spirit spouse that's
okay.
in my life.
Okay. So the Lord showed you that there was a spirit wife involved.
Yeah, he showed me that. He told me, I listened to a lot of your sessions and your teachings.
Mm-hmm.
He even spilled to me when it came in.
Okay, what did he say?
I'm sorry?
I said, what did the Lord say? How it came in?
Okay, when I was around 5 or 6, my parents used to send us down south for the summer to stay with our grandmother. And there was an uncle down there that when it's bedtime, we would be sent up to the attic. They had like an attic, and they sent us kids up there. And he would molest us.
Mm.
And I can remember many occasions waking up in the morning, and he would be over me.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
And this happened many times.
And did you find yourself throughout life having homosexual tendencies?
Yes.
Yeah, and that was the reason why.
Yes, and I do understand that now.
You see it clearly now. I always made it. A year ago, you couldn't see it clearly.
I couldn't see it clearly. I knew I had the bondage, but I didn't understand how it all came about.
God is so good. Thank you, Jesus. But what's important, Demetri, you heed to God's warning and want to be set free. Now, are you married today? Are you married?
No, I'm divorced.
Are you divorced? And how long were you married?
I was married for like 5 years.
5 years. Well, believe it or not, your wife had a spirit husband because darkness only is attracted to darkness.
Okay.
Yeah. So that divorce just won't do to your fault, but also her fault as well. Both you two needed to be delivered, then counseled, then you could be free to marry. Your marriage would have lasted. Jesus. Do you have any children?
Yes, I have a son.
You have a son? Now, do she have a son?
Yes, she does.
Okay, do you have visitation rights with?
Oh, yes. She's remarried, and we have a decent relationship. And,
okay.
Me and my son have a good relationship, too.
Oh, great. So after your deliverance, you're going to have to put your hands on your son because that spirit is in that son. If it's in the father and the mother and you are the child's covering, that spirit is in the son, being dormant, waiting to a particular time to manifest through his behavior and ways.
Yes.
Okay?
And I have been thinking about that and been concerned about that after learning all of this.
Yeah, that's the Lord who helped me to think on that. Yeah. The devil's
and then,
alive. Mm-hmm.
And then let me share this also. And then when I came across all this information and started watching your videos and things and started praying against it. Let me just back up just a quick sec. I was like in heavy bondage with the pornography, with the alcohol. I mean, it was really bad. But the Lord cleaned all that up for me, right? But then I still had the problem with the lust, right, with the eyes, right? And I couldn't get free of that at all. Even though he took the pornography away, the alcohol, the drinking, everything, smoking cigarettes, he took that away too. He took secular TV. He took movies away. I mean, this is just God just doing this, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I've been trying to walk as closely to him as I can and to stay in prayer and in the Word. And when I first prayed against this spirit spouse, the next morning when I woke up, I heard it talking to me. They were saying, I don't want to leave your life. And, you know, and I had an erection and all that. And it was saying, I don't want to leave your life. But I kept praying against it. I pray against it every day, you know, because I want to be free from it. And then it just started tormenting me. And I just got a lot of torment, like even in my mind and everything, you know, like trying to make me feel like I just want to die sometimes, you know, the torment gets so bad.
Mm-hmm.
But then it told me that if you stop praying, the torment will go away. But naturally, I know that that's just a lie.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just keep praying against it. But today, the Lord told me to just be still today and just rest in his presence and just spend time with him today. And don't think about nothing else but him. So I did that. I set aside this day. And I was just resting in the Lord and just thinking about him, just praising him and reading the Word. And then he just put on my heart to call today out of the mm-hmm. blue. He just put on my heart, not call. Praise God.
God is so good. So good.
And then let me share this too. It was hard waiting. But when I heard your voice say, you in California, if you just hang on. I said, okay, I can make it.
When I said that, I felt God was saying that through me.
You don't know how comforting those words was at the time because this thing was acting up even while I was on the phone when I had to wait and listen to the other callers.
It was trying to get you to leave. It did not want to hear that stuff. We're trying to get you to leave. I said, come on, get this. Hang on.
But
I know, I'm
hanging up.
God
Amen.
Is so good. He is so good. A lot of times, Lord, do that. I don't know why he does, but I just obey and just do it. But I'm like, Lord.
I needed to hear that at that time, too. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. Sometimes, you know, I'll be having a lot of calls, and I said, Lord, I know the devil through those people. They need to listen. I know them devils are listening. And the Lord said, yeah, tell them, don't, if they hang up, call back. You know, acknowledge that you're going to call them, say something, because, yeah, those devils out there trying, they cannot stand listening, and they're trying to convince them to hang up. Like, there were a couple yesterday, they hung up, but I said, Lord, Michigan hung up, and Wisconsin, I said, well, they'll call, but let them call back tomorrow, and they did, they called back today. Because it comes up on my control panel, and I look, the Holy Spirit tell me, yeah, I sent this one to be delivered. I sent this one. See, I already know what God's plan and purpose is, but praise God, Demetria. Just thank God. He's going to set you totally free from that spirit wife who's using spirit lust to keep you bound. Matter of fact, he's going to deliver you from every spirit that's in you that's not of him, that just some you don't even know by name, but they're going to go too, okay? But the main thing is after your deliverance, when your son is over, you know, put your hands on his head and bless him. Let him hear you bless him. And when you speak deliverance to him, because he's listening, you know, keep a low tone, because demons are not deaf. They can hear it. You're not dealing with a deaf spirit. They can hear it. And don't say demon, because that will put fear in the child, and devils will use that fear to not leave. But you say every spirit that is not of the Holy Spirit, I command you to come out of my son, mind, will, emotions, and body, every spirit. There's not a whole spirit. That is the words that you use instead of using demon.
Okay.
Okay. Because you give you demon to put fear in him, and he will be fearful, and those devils won't leave because of that spirit. But you say every spirit, and you are talking to it. You're not talking to your son. But you're looking at your son, and you're smiling at your son. But in your heart, you're coming against those spirits because they are in there hiding.
Right.
And Matter of fact, just before you do deliverance, you know, ask him about his dream. Ask him if he sees things at night. Do you happen to see things? You know, get some type of history of what he's dealing with, what he's dealing with, not sharing with you all. Okay.
Okay.
But then you say every spirit that's not a holy spirit. Praise the holy name of God. All right, Demetrius, I'm going to speak a prayer over you. Then by faith, we're going to command spirit wife in Jesus' name to come out of God's house. You are God's property. They have no more legal right. And you stay in submission to God, okay?
Yes.
Make sure your computer stay clean.
Yes.
Stay clean. And I hope that you have delete your cookies and clear your browsers of those pornographic links. If you have numbers of young ladies in there and that you know they're not godly women of God, you need to get rid of them. You have email address, you need to get rid of them. You need to get rid of those attachments. Okay?
Okay.
Focus your relationship on him, and you let the Lord deal with your earthly relationship. He knows when. Okay?
Okay.
All right? It's yes. important. Now, it's important for you because I've never seen before, but I believe you're a handsome young man, and what's going to happen is the devil's going to send a lot of women your way. You remind me of my friend out there in California. I told him the same thing, and he's like, man, can't go away.
I suspect that.
Be careful now. They're not going to be no ugly-looking women, but lo and behold, you're going to be looking at snakes. They are nothing but snakes in the spirit realm. So keep your eyes on. Matter of fact, I'm asking the Lord to open up your spirit eyes as I asked the Lord to do with this other young man so you can actually see the spirit that they are in obedience to. So don't be surprised you see a half woman and a half snake.
Okay.
Or you see a half woman, a half lizard. You see some type of animal spirit. You're like, what in the world? You'll be rubbing your eyes. What is this? The Lord started with me showing you the spirit that is inside of them, who they are in obedience to. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Now, these things are going to happen after you deliver, because after I deliver, we are free.
Those
no longer got us bound. We are free to see truth, and you will actually see these things. Okay.
And they want to get back in, right?
So I'm going to go ahead and pray. So, Father, here again, I just thank you for this amazing opportunity you've given me today to minister your grace and mercy to your dear children and especially to Demetrius. I thank you, Father, that every plan, purpose, idea that you have for Demetrius in bringing glory only to Jesus Christ on this earth, it shall be fulfilled. I thank you, Father, for protecting him and his family, Father. Thank you, Father, for giving him an in-depth revelation of who he is in Jesus, who Jesus is in him, and teaching him to develop that friendship with Jesus Christ and developing his relationship with Jesus Christ. I just thank you for making yourself known unto him, Father. Give him visions and dreams, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Make him an amazing man of God, and that which you call for him to be upon this earth, I thank you, Father. He shall be an exceedingly great prophet of God at your time, not his time, but at your time, Father. But in the meantime, Father, I thank you for raising him and appointing him and showing him the way, teaching him step by step, line by line, step by feature. God, mighty words, Lord. I just thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. I thank you for the cleansing that you're doing him as I speak and mention this prayer, Father. For you are mighty, you are glorious, Father. You have a great plan for this young man and his son, Father, in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Father, for cleansing the house this day. So, in Jesus' name, now, spirit wife, you know you got to go. You know you got to go in Jesus' name. So you just come on out. You just pass the spirit love with you. And every spirit that's not a spirit, and you can leave God's house now. Just get on out of his house now in Jesus' name. Because the blood of Jesus has forgiven him and his ancestors. The blood of Jesus has set him free. The blood of Jesus has wrapped him out and laid for him in full. The blood of Jesus is against you. And you come out of his mind. 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 Holy Ghost fire. Burn all the negative images out of his mind. Burn every negative word of thought that's been given in his mind. Burn by your fire. Burn, Holy Spirit, all manner of darkness and evil that is working hard in his mind, burn. Let it come out of his mind now in Jesus' name. The Spirit of God detaches him from you, spirit wife, in the spirit realm. The blood of Jesus, who is the true judge, nullifies that marriage in the spirit realm, detaches him in the mighty name of Jesus. You come out of his will. Come out of his emotion now. You come out of his body. You loose his private area. Holy Ghost fire, burn in his private area. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in Jesus' name. Burn everywhere on his body that they hold. There's an opening. Even there is a mark that is known or unknown to him. Burn by the fire, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for sending your angel in the spirit realm and dispatching every spirit that's not of you and sending them where you desire to send them, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I ask you now to fill Demetria, fill his mind with your spirit, fill his will with your spirit, fill his emotion with your spirit, and fill his body with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Demetria, you are free. You are free to serve the Lord that God in your mind, in your will, in your emotions, and in your body. You are free indeed in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for you are merciful and grateful. We just thank you. We glorify you. We magnify you this day, Father, for cleansing your house. Father, now I pray for Demetria's place, Father. Holy Ghost fire, I ask you to burn in Demetria's house. Burn in his room. Go in every room. Go under the bed, over the bed, around the bed. Go in every closet. Burn where there is darkness lurking and hiding. Burn, Holy Spirit, don't leave no area untouched by your fire. Go even under the house. Over the house, around the house, go even under the ground of the house. Burn, Holy Spirit, for the amount of darkness that lurk and even in hiding, Holy Spirit. Burn by your fire in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name for setting this captive free. We magnify you, we glorify you always, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
You
continue to fill them with your spirit, Father. Let them feel your love, your warmth, your compassion, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father. We hope that made all this, Father. Told his news, made new and told this day, Father. In my name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your holy name, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. We praise you. We adore you always, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Praise his holy name.
Yes,
now,
yes.
You see why them demons are trying to get you to hang up?
Yes. Yes. They knew what was going to happen. Yes.
I had me a finish praying to my father, and them things were coming out.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Jesus, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
We glorify you. We thank you.
Praise God.
Glory
thank
to
you.
Your holy name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. I have a guest on the line, and they say amen. Thank you, God. Thank God. Amen.
Amen.
Lord. Woo,
wow.
It is done, Demetria. And just think, Demetria, this could have happened a year ago.
I know. It could have happened a year ago, yes.
A year ago. You know, Jesus,
a lot of stuff in between.
Jesus,
I know.
A year ago, you just won't read. But Jesus was waiting. You know, we tell the Lord, more you, Lord. The Lord said, more of you. Jesus
waiting
on us.
Yes.
He's waiting on us.
Yes, he's waiting on us, right?
It
amen.
Is good.
And I thank him for his patience.
Amen. Yes, he is. He's patient and long-suffering. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Now, what part of California are you in?
I'm out right outside of Los Angeles, San Bernardino.
That's where my friend is. He's in Los Angeles. I haven't heard from him in a while, and I know he called the other day, but he didn't leave a message. I said, boy, he got to leave a message. The Lord told me if they don't leave a message, don't call them back.
Oh, okay.
So he had to leave that mess. Oh, that's Miranda. Miranda from Florida. Hey, just listening. Well, I know you blessed, Miranda. That's a guest who's tuning in over the website to the program. And if you tune on the website, you can listen. You can chat, write, chat.
Oh, okay, okay.
So I was reading her comments. She was thanking and praising God for your deliverance.
Wow, praise
God. Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah, praise God. Amen. Now you go and you share, Dimitri, what great things God has done for you, because there are many other young men.
I want you to share this.
In the church, they're going through the same thing, but they ain't telling nobody. The devil said, keep it their dirty little secret. And they do that so they won't get free. And you share what great things God has done for you. He set you
free. I will not be ashamed of what he did for me today.
Because, Dimitri, if you had never confessed to that molestation at 5, you would have never gotten free, because Spirit Wife would have used that as a legal right to stay in you, because you have to confess to your wrongdoings in order for God to have mercy and grace upon you. But when you made that, and a confession like that is not easy, especially for a man.
Yes.
It's more simple for a woman. They'll quickly admit to it, but a man,
right.
And then for you to confess that that homosexual tendencies, you would have never confessed that thing. You would have never been free. You would have ended up being gay.
Right. And I thank
you. You've been gay. And then bisexual, gay, you went both ways. And after then, you would have graduated to the next step, start looking at animals and start buying sex with. Do you not know out in California, even in church, you think a lot of people have cats and dogs as a pet? Do you not know they are their sexual partner?
I know things are really, really getting bad out there, you know? So I know all kinds of things are going on.
Mm-hmm. And I'm talking about in the church, too, right there in the church.
Right.
It's dangerous. If you own a cat or a dog, it's very dangerous for you to have that animal keep licking you in your mouth.
Oh, yeah.
That is disgusting.
I do wonder about that when I see that.
Uh-huh. Then, you know, at first you say, oh, I love it. It's just plant. No. That demon and that animal got other plans for you. That's why it's
the wrong
kissing you in the mouth, licking you all in the mouth.
Yeah.
Come on now. You have to be careful about it. I tell you, this is going on. This is going on more than you know of, right? In the church.
Yeah.
And in the church. So the Lord said, you go, you share, and you tell what great things God has done for you. And the truth is, matter of fact, this young man out in California who got delivered. And the demon came back, and I said, Lord, what door did he open? And finally, you know, the Lord told him, and he had to make another confession.
Okay.
Because he heard me say these things, but he didn't confess to
I know exactly what you were talking about. I did listen to that.
Mm-hmm. He didn't confess to bestiality. And I said, now you heard me talk about it. He said, you know, he felt ashamed. I said, no, that was the enemy. I said, plus, it don't come surprise to me, because when you get one sexual demon, you happen to get them all. It's just a matter of time that you start advancing, in the kingdom of darkness, to the point that you desire to have sex with animals, and you will commit sexual acts with animals. So it wouldn't be surprised to me, because again, when you get one such a thing, you get them all. You catch these young boys and young girls having sexual intercourse all the time. You know, they get all those demons, and that's why can they end up being bisexual. And then again, you know, after bisexual, they start going to bestiality, and they start having these pick bulls. You think they're just having them to fight? Nah.
Right. Because they just pulling deeper and deeper, right?
They get deeper and deeper into darkness.
Yeah.
And that's what's going on. But praise God that you made that confession, and now you see you got totally free. So that spirit wife knew it had no more legal ground to stay. It just adds. You know.
Praise the Lord.
So I just remind the Lord of his word. The Lord the one who does it. I'm not no deliverer. I just remind him of his word. See, I believe that when I remind him of his word on this earth, he does it in heaven. He asks us to believe. All it takes is for us to believe. Amen. Amen. Okay, now you stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. I mean, that has been a different day for me. This is, I think I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've done 4. 4 would always be my limit, but I went 1 more over.
Well, praise the Lord.
So you're looking at 9 sessions in 2 days. So that's a record for me. That's a record for me.
Lord.
It's no matter what God can use. I'd be tired, right? But I pray, I said, Lord, give me spiritual strength and give me physical strength. Because what you don't realize, this is spiritual warfare. It's spiritual warfare. This is no joke.
Amen.
It's no joke, Demetrius.
Yeah, it's not. You're absolutely right. And I learned that the hard way, but I learned it.
Mm-hmm.
I learned it.
It's no joke.
I know now to stay as close to Jesus as I can every day.
Amen. Amen. And that's how we maintain our deliverance. We stay submitted to God.
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And, Francis King, before you go, the Lord just spoke to me to sow a seed into your ministry. How can I do that?
Well, you can just go to the website, you know, for my website, childrenmike.org.
Okay.
The childrenmike.org, that's the website. And click on donations. And you can pay right through PayPal.
Okay, great.
Send it right through PayPal.
Praise the Lord.
Because I'm trusting the Lord that that we be coming out to California. I want to hold a deliverance meeting out there.
Okay.
But I'm waiting on the finances. And he gave me, you know, he already given me some contacts.
You come out here, I'll be a volunteer and help out.
All right, yeah, because I'm definitely needing help.
Let me down.
Yep. I remember you.
Okay.
So do me a favor, Demetrius. When you go to the website and do that donation, also make sure you add your phone number so I can have your phone number and put it in my phone. So if when God makes it happen, then I can contact you.
Okay. I will do that.
Okay. All right, stay blessed, all right?
Okay, God bless you, and thank you.
You too.
Okay,
bye-bye. Amen. You're right, Miranda. I've done a lot of praying today because, you know, this week, like I said, seven sessions, I believe. That's the highest that I've done so far. But I thank God for giving me a change. In deliverance sessions, where I no longer do private sessions, I do public sessions. And this seems to be more effective because by doing private sessions, it shows me that people who call are serious because they're willing to share their session. They're not ashamed of the Lord. And so it's much more effective and productive in doing public sessions, praise his holy. So here, Miranda must have did some more research on the African black soap that y'all hear me talk with Anita about. And she said, she wrote, Evangelist King, you are true. Where did it go? Oh, there, here it is. True woman of God and prophet. She said, I Googled black African soap ritual. You were right. May God continue to use you. And yes, ma'am, I agree. It's more effective to maintain deliverance. Amen. Yeah, you know, I felt like that soap, and I think Nita's probably still on the line, but yeah, that soap, that African soap, just didn't bear witness with my spirit, with my spirit and the spirit of God. Put it that way, because the Holy Spirit do work with our spirit. It just didn't bear witness with the spirit of God through my spirit. That it was of God. It is some type of ritual. And again, when you use it, you take a bath, you think about you bathing your body. That is an Anytime you bathe your body with something, that is an initiation. If it's not regular cleaning soap where you bathing, you know, washing filth off of your body, then that soap is initiating you into the kingdom of darkness. The soap, now the soap itself is not evil, but think about the black African soap. That's the purpose of black African soap. I guarantee you they prayed over that soap as they had their initiation, so that whoever would buy it and use it would be initiated in the kingdom of God. I'm still going to ask my African friend, he's a pastor and an evangelist, deliverance minister, about it, because he probably more knowledgeable about it than I am. But I'm just telling you what the Holy Spirit is telling me, that it's not of him. You know what we want, we just want to use a regular soap to clean our body. That's it. You know, why it got to be a black African soap? Praise his holy name. So again, dear heart, I want to thank everyone for tuning in today. And remember, I have live call-in deliverance session every Wednesday, Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can call 724-444-7444. Enter call ID 139732. Praise his holy name. So, dear heart, you continue to stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name.